Hello, welcome back to the channel Awesome Learning. We have already discussed about algae. Now today we are going to discuss about bryophytes. In class 9th we have studied that bryophytes are also known as plant amphibians. Why do we call them as plant amphibians? Because they complete their life cycle both on land and water. That means their life cycle cannot be completed unless there is water. Okay, so that is why they are called plant amphibians. So let's begin with bryophytes, children. See, they are called amphibians of plant kingdom. I just told you why. Because they can live in soil but need water for sexual reproduction. Okay. They require water for sexual reproduction. They occur in damp, humid and shaded localities. Kyunki water bahut zaruri hai to complete the life cycle. So children, bryophytes body is more differentiated than that of algae. Now, as I told you when we were studying about algae that they are very simple. And I told you why do we call them as simple? Because the body is not differentiated into true roots, stem or leaves. Okay. Here, but in bryophytes, though they do not have, now please mark my words. Please mark my words. Even bryophytes do not have true roots, stems or leaves, but their body is differentiated more than that of alga. That means agar hum alga aur bryophytes ko compare kare to bryophytes ki body jo hai that is little bit differentiated. Halanki inke paas bhi true roots, stem or leaves nahi hai. It is thallus like and prostrate or erect, as you see here, erect and attached to the substratum by unicellular or multicellular rhizoids. These are the rhizoids. The root like structure that you see are called rhizoids, and these rhizoids help the plant to attach to any kind of substratum. The substratum can be a wall, it can be a floor, a rock, whatever. So here, now as I told you that they do not have true roots, but they have root-like structures which are known as rhizoids. Similarly, they do not have true stems, but they have stem-like structures and leaf-like structures. Okay, so they possess root-like, leaf-like or stem-like structures. As you see, अब इस diagram को देखें, तो figure को एक छोटे बच्चे को अगर आप पूछोगे ना, तो that kid will say कि these are the roots. Now this is the stem and these are the leaves. These are the leaves, right? So they actually are not true root, stem or leaves, but yes, they appear to be root-like, leaf-like or stem-like structures. The main plant body is haploid. Now children, you have to be very, very attentive when you are studying this. Okay, now please pay attention. What is a gametophyte? Now as the name suggests, gametes are always haploid. Gametes are always haploid. So the structure which bears the gamete is called gametophyte. The structure which bears the gamete or which produces the gamete is called gametophyte. So here the main plant body, as you see, this is the main plant body, is gametophyte, and gametophytes are always haploid. Okay, so the main plant body is haploid. It produces gametes. Hence, it is called gametophyte. So, agar hum aapse puche ki bryophytes mein one mark question can be asked that in bryophytes, what is the main plant body? So, the answer is the main plant body is gametophyte. Now, if I ask you, are gametophytes haploid or diploid? Yes, they are always haploid. So main part of the body or main plant body is gametophyte, and gametophytes are always haploid. Clear? Now let's see further. The sex organs in bryophytes are multicellular. As I told you, gametophyte, yani gametophyte is that part which produces gametes. And because I can see this plant through my naked eyes, that means it is a multicellular plant. Now if it is a multicellular plant body, और मैंने ये भी अभी थोड़ी देर पहले कहा कि main plant body is gametophyte, that means if it is visible to naked eyes, that tells us that gametophyte is multicellular. It is made up of many cells. So sex organs in bryophytes are multicellular. Male sex organ is called antheridium. And it produces biflagellate. Now, what do you mean by biflagellate? Two flagellas. And those gametes are called anthrozoids. Now, you see, anthrozoids are the gametes, male gametes, and they are produced inside antheridium. Similarly, female sex organ is archegonium, which is flask-shaped, and it produces the female gamete, that is single egg. Okay, as you see in the diagram, see this is archegonium and these are the eggs. Okay, archegonium, this is female gametophyte and the archegonium with egg. Right, similarly here male gametophyte antheridium is sperm. Okay, so they have shown you archegonia and antheridia in Markensia. Markensia is a kind of liverwort. Okay, and see, this is how male and female thallus look like. These diagrams are present in your NCERT also. A liverwort, Markensias. This is the female thallus. You see rhizoids. Okay, these are the green, dark green color cups called gamma cups. And this is archegoniophore on which archegonium is placed. And this is male thallus, and because it is a male thallus, so it will have antheridiophore, which is having antheridium. Okay, so this is female and male thallus, and this is about the sex organs produced in bryophytes. Now, anthrozoids, as you see, anthrozoids are released. What are anthrozoids? Anthrozoids are male gamete. Okay, anthrozoids are male gamete and they are released to water and meet archegonium. So understood why I was saying you that bryophytes are called plant amphibians, because for sexual reproduction they require water. Now if sexual reproduction has to take place, sexual reproduction is a reproduction where the two gametes have to meet. Okay, so anthrozoids or the male gametes are released in water and they swim and they reach archegonium to meet, to fuse with them. Now when anthrozoids fuses with the egg, what is formed? Of course, zygote is formed. Okay, so further, zygotes do not undergo meiosis. Now children, you see here, as I told you, these are anthrozoids and egg. They are already N, haploid, haploid. N plus N will form a zygote, which is 2N, that is diploid. So zygotes are diploid. So these zygotes will not undergo meiosis immediately. They will not undergo meiosis immediately. They produce a multicellular body called sporophyte. Yaad hai, algas mein it was just the opposite. Alga mein kya hua tha? Zygotes immediately underwent meiosis. Let me show you. Let me take you back. If I could show you that. See. This was the life cycle. Yeah. See? Zygote, if you remember, 2N zygote. And immediately after the formation of zygote, meiosis occurred and zoospores were formed, right? But here, this is not the case. In bryophytes, it won't happen. So, what will happen here? The zygote which is formed will not undergo meiosis immediately. This zygote will grow and this zygote will multiply further. and will make a multicellular body. That is called sporophyte. Now, if you see this figure, children, here, this is the figure of a bryophyte. The half plant was is named as gametophyte, and this half is sporophyte. So, a multicellular body is formed, which is called sporophyte. So, bryophytes ka jo pura life cycle hai, that is divided into two parts. आधा लाइफ साइकिल इज वो जीता है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ गेमेटोफाइट एंड बाकी का आधा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ स्पोरोफाइट. बट अगर आपसे पूछें कि मेन प्लांट कौन सा है, मेन प्लांट बॉडी ब्रायोफाइट्स में कौन है, तो दैट इज अ गेमेटोफाइट. मेन प्लांट बॉडी इज हैप्लॉइड, दैट इज गेमेटोफाइट. बट इसी गेमेटोफाइट में जो गेमीट्स निकले एंड द गेमीट्स फ्यूज्ड टुगेदर टू फॉर्म जाइगोट. अब वो जाइगोट एक सेल का जो था दैट मल्टीप्लाइज एंड इट बिकम्स अ मल्टी सेल्यूलर. यू सी दैट जाइगोट मल्टीप्लाइज एंड बिकम्स अ मल्टी सेल्यूलर पार्ट विच वी कॉल अ स्पोरोफाइट. तो यानी गेमेटोफाइट मेन प्लांट बॉडी हुई ना, क्योंकि गेमेटोफाइट के ऊपर स्पोरोफाइट बियर कर रहा है. देखो गेमेटोफाइट ने स्पोरोफाइट को संभाल रखा है ना. सो दैट इज व्हाई गेमेटोफाइट इज द मेन प्लांट बॉडी. तो आई रिपीट दिस अगेन विद यू. जाइगोट्स डू नॉट अंडरगो मियोसिस इमीडिएटली. दे प्रोड्यूस अ मल्टी सेल्यूलर बॉडी, ओके, विच इज कॉल्ड स्पोरोफाइट. Now, sporophyte is not free living. As you see, sporophytes are not free living. They are attached to the gametophyte. So, sporophyte akeli zindagi nahi jee sakta, free living nahi hai, but it is attached to photosynthetic gametophyte. Yani, wo sporophyte apne khane ke liye bhi gametophyte ke upar depend karta hai, kyunki gametophyte ke paas leaf-like structure hai. गेमेटोफाइट के पास लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर है और वो फोटोसिंथेसिस करके फूड बनाएगा एंड दैट फूड विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू स्पोरोफाइट आल्सो. सो इट मींस दैट स्पोरोफाइट जो है दैट इज नॉट फ्री लिविंग. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द गेमेटोफाइट फॉर फूड और नरिशमेंट. सम सेल्स ऑफ स्पोरोफाइट अंडरगो मियोसिस. नाउ मियोसिस विल अकर. थोड़ी देर स्पोरोफाइट बन गया, स्पोरोफाइट गेमेटोफाइट के ऊपर आ गया और वो एक टाइम बिताता है और उसके थोड़े टाइम के बाद आफ्टर सम टाइम मियोसिस विल अकर इन द स्पोरोफाइट. एंड मियोसिस होगा तो क्या होगा, रिडक्शन डिवीजन होगी. तो दैट मींस हैप्लॉइड स्पोर्स विल बी फॉर्म्ड. Okay, so haploid spores will be formed and these spores, wherever they will fall, they will germinate again to form a gametophyte next generation. Ek gametophyte, jahan bhi wo spore girega, wahan par ek new gametophyte paida hoga. Ab phir se ye gametophyte ek main plant body banega, phir usme se gametes banenge, gametes fuse honge. गेमीट्स जब फ्यूज होंगे जाइगोट बनेगा, वो जाइगोट मल्टीप्लाई करके एक स्पोरोफाइट बनाएगा और वो स्पोरोफाइट किससे अटैच्ड है, मेन प्लांट से यानी गेमेटोफाइट से अटैच्ड है. सो अगेन द लाइफ साइकिल विल रिपीट. यू सी द लाइफ साइकिल ऑफ लिवरॉट, दिस इज शोन हियर. दिस इज फीमेल गेमेटोफाइट, दिस इज मेल गेमेटोफाइट. दे हैव आर्चिगोनियल हेड, दिस इज एंथरीडियल हेड. इसमें एंथरीडियाज है यानी स्पर्म्स है, दीज आर द स्पर्म्स. हियर आर्चिगोनिया यानी एग्स. ओके, सो दे विल फ्यूज टू फॉर्म जाइगोट. देन दीज जाइगोट्स विल फर्दर मल्टीप्लाई टू फॉर्म अ स्पोरोफाइट. So I hope you have understood that bryophyte has the life cycle of bryophytes are divided into two parts. The main plant body is gametophyte and then the sporophyte. The sporophyte is actually dependent on gametophyte for nourishment and other things. And when the meiosis will occur in few cells of sporophyte, spores will be formed and wherever these spores will fall, they will again germinate and give rise to a new gametophyte. So I hope you have understood how the life cycle of bryophytes take place. In the next video, we will be doing the importance of bryophytes.